You might be saying to yourself, wait a minute, I know these guys. I've heard their music. How are they unsung? Well, popular as they may have been, truth be told, they may actually have been underappreciated in their time and less well-known than they ought to be, given their place and significance in Black and American music history. Keep watching to see what I mean. Louis Jordan is a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and is described there as the father of rhythm and blues and the grandfather of rock and roll. He has directly influenced other legends with his work, such as Chuck Berry and B.B. King. Louis Jordan was a bridge builder. He had crossover success with both Black and white audiences at the same time, as during his lifetime and the time of his greatest popularity, even the pop music charts were segregated. He was also noted for creating soundies, early versions of what we now call music videos, way back in the early 1940s. Here's an excerpt from a recording of one of his biggest hits.
Hey boy, hey boy, hey, what you doing, man? Cut it. Hey, what you gonna do? That ain't the piece we supposed to play. Come on. Well, I guess I better get on in here with it. But she's my baby, and I love her just the same. Crazy about that woman, 'cause Caledonia is her name. Caledonia! Caledonia! What make your big head so hard? Mouth! I love you. Love you just the same. I'll always love you, baby, 'cause Caledonia is your name. Caledonia's bad for your morale, son. Keep away from her. But Mama didn't know I was in love with Caledonia. So I'm going down to Caledonia's house and ask her just one more time. Caledonia! Caledonia! What make your big head so hot?
Nat King Cole, born Nathaniel Adam Coles, was a jazz pianist and singer who epitomized words like smooth, warm, and friendly, both with his music and his personality. Nat King Cole was a virtuoso jazz pianist whose jazz trio pioneered and set the standard for the small format jazz ensembles that followed them. Jazz, however, was losing steam as the premier popular music genre during the time in which Cole's trio was growing in popularity, leading to a change in his music style, pop singing. His signature smooth singing voice was discovered almost by accident, but once discovered, he simply had to keep using it. In between the transition from jazz music to pop music, Cole actually released some Latin music albums, sung in Spanish, in Cuba, to great success. He was tremendously successful throughout his 30-year musical career, despite facing incredible disdain from his fans that were upset with his transition away from jazz music, as well as from both sides of the racial divide. He was peers with the likes of Perry Como, Dean Martin, and Tony Bennett, and recorded over 100 songs that became hits on the pop charts during his most productive years, making him second only to the great Frank Sinatra during that time frame. Nat King Cole was so well liked and personable that he was the first Black or African American man to host an American television series. Here's an excerpt of one of his most well-remembered songs, Unforgettable.
Oh, but here tonight I'm glad that I found a place to park, because right now I'd like to sing for you a very wonderful oldie entitled Unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Before has someone been more unforgettable in every way?
If Louis Jordan was the grandfather of rock and roll, Little Richard, born Richard Wayne Pennyman, was undoubtedly the father of rock and roll. In fact, his nickname reads more like a proper title: the innovator, the originator, and the architect of rock and roll. Little Richard's most celebrated works date back to the mid-1950s, neatly following after the works of Louis Jordan, but his music career lasted over 70 years. As his nickname suggests, Little Richard laid the foundation for rock and roll music specifically, and also heavily influenced just about every other major modern American music genre that came after with his body of work. He was a barrier breaker and bridge builder in that his music brought Black and white audiences together, breaking long-established color lines despite attempts to keep people segregated. Many musicians of his day covered his works and owe at least a part of their successes to him, including Jerry Lee Lewis, Eddie Cochran, Buddy Holly, and even Elvis. Little Richard was such a big deal that when he traveled to Europe to tour there in the mid-1960s, a group of four young British musicians named the Beatles would open or begin some of his tour performances. You heard that right. The Beatles opened for Little Richard. Little Richard even advised the Beatles on how to perform his songs. Pretty cool, huh? Let's listen to one of Little Richard's most popular tunes, Tutti Frutti.
You made a dancing to Little Richard and Tutti Frutti.
The story of Marvin Gaye is one of personal growth and perseverance through adversity, both professionally and personally. It could be said that his failures and failings are as much a reflection of his greatness as his tremendous successes. Marvin began to put successes together, first as a musician for the legendary recording label Motown Records, then as a singer for the label. The next step on his way to success was recording wildly popular duets with the likes of Tammy Terrell and Diana Ross, who we discussed in the previous episode. Then, Marvin went on to have solo successes to the tune of millions of records sold. It was at this point that he faced a dilemma. The record company did not want to release the type of music he wanted to sing, music that talked about what was going on in the world at that time. It was during this moment of turmoil that Marvin Gaye produced perhaps his most timeless works, using his talent, celebrity, and influence to speak up for what he believed in and to draw attention to issues affecting those he cared about in a very impactful way. Listen to some of the lyrics of two of his greatest hits, What's Going On and Mercy, Mercy Me, while considering that these two songs were written and recorded just short of 50 years ago.
Whoa, oh, mercy, mercy me. All things ain't what they used to be now. Where did all the blue skies go? Poison is the wind that blows from the north and south and east. Oh, mercy, mercy me. Mercy. All things and what they used to be lost. Oil wasted on the oceans and upon our seas. Fish full of mercury. Oh, mercy, mercy me. All things
they used to do. Lost matter, radiation underground and in the sky. Animals and birds who live near Baba's lies. Mercy, mercy me. All things and what they used to be. What about this overcrowded land? How much more be you from man? Can't you stand?
Of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Father, father, we don't need to escape. War's not the answer, for only love can conquer. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving. Oh, yeah, yeah. Picket lights, picket signs, punish me with brutality. Talk to me, honey, so you can see. Oh, what's going on? What's going on? Hey, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. Woo!
Come on here.
Woo! Oh, yeah, baby. Whee!
Prince Rogers Nelson, or Prince as he was known, was one of the greatest all-around musicians and talents of his generation. He had a wide vocal range that extended from baritone to high falsetto. He played several instruments, all of them well, but was a guitar virtuoso and is recognized amongst the best of the best on that instrument. He was known for having a tenacious work ethic, very much like James Brown, the hardest working man in show business. We'll get into James Brown in another episode. He's kind of a big deal. Prince released 39 albums during his life, with the belief that there are dozens of unreleased projects stored away in a vault at his home. Prince also wrote, produced, for and collaborated with other artists very often, even if he was uncredited for doing so. It's estimated that he has written well over 1,000 songs in total. At the peak of his powers, Prince did amazing things. Keeping in mind that Prince is not an actor or movie star, Prince starred in his own movie and made the entire soundtrack for the movie. He then went on to win a Grammy, a music award, and an Academy Award, a movie award, for that same movie and soundtrack. But wait, it gets better. Prince, at one point, had the number one album, number one single, and number one movie in the United States all at the same time. He is the first singer to ever accomplish that feat. And he was the feature performer at Super Bowl 41, which is a big deal seeing as there has only ever been 55 of them, ever, in all of history. Here's some footage of Prince performing Purple Rain, one of his most enduring hits, at three different points in his storied career.
Never meant to cause you any sorrow. I never meant to cause you any pain. I didn't want to one time see you laughing, babe. Only want to see you laughing, yeah, in the purple rain, purple. Don't it feel good? Only wanna see you, see you. Can I play this guitar? Never meant to cause you any sorrow. Never meant to cause you any pain. Yeah. I don't want to one time see you laugh. Only want to see you laugh. The purple rain. Purple.
Hey there, I'm glad you made it all the way here to the end of episode 2. Stay tuned for episode 3 of Barrier Breakers, where we get into some real heavy hitters and trendsetters. You do not want to miss a second of it, so make sure you like and subscribe, comment below, and ring the bell for alerts. See you soon.